7-year-old Congress DMK tie is now on a breakpoint as both parties have refused to budge from their stand. And as many as 6 DMK ministers are set to meet the Prime Minister and submit their resignations today. Now, a day after Congress's second biggest ally decided to withdraw support from the Manmohan Singh cabinet, both parties have toughened their stance. DMK chief Karunanidhi has gone on to say that alliance with other parties could be possible.
நேரடியாக பிரதமர் அவர்களை சந்தித்து என்னுடைய ராஜினாமா கடிதங்களை கொடுத்து விட்டு வருவோம்.
சார், காங்கிரஸோட நீங்க இப்ப போட்டி ஆடுறது உங்களுக்கு சந்தோஷமா இருக்கா இல்லையா? காங்கிரஸோட நீங்க இப்ப போட்டி ஆடுறது உங்களுக்கு, நீங்க அதை பத்தி என்ன நினைக்கிறீங்க?
அது அவங்களாக விளக்குறாங்க, அதுக்கு நாங்க என்ன பண்ண முடியும்? அவங்க தேவையில்லைன்னு போறாங்க. யாரும் பேசுறது வரையும் யாரும் பேச அது அது தலைமை கழகத்தை தான் கேட்கணும். தலைவர் தான் இல்ல, யாரையும் சந்திக்கிறது
எங்க கட்சியினுடைய உயர்மட்ட குழுவினுடைய முடிவின்படி, எங்களுடைய கழக தலைவர் தலைவர் கலைஞருடைய அறிவுறுத்தலின்படி, நாங்கள் மந்திரி சபையில் இடம்பெற்றிருக்கிற நாங்கள் 6 பேரும் இன்னைக்கு பாரத பிரதமர் டாக்டர் ஐயா மன்மோகன் சிங்கை 11 மணிக்கு சந்திச்சு நாங்கள் எங்களுடைய ரெசிக்னேஷன் கொடுக்குறோம். அதெல்லாம் நீங்கள் தலைவர்கிட்ட கேட்க வேண்டிய கேள்வியெல்லாம் என்கிட்ட கேட்கக்கூடாது. நான் தொண்டன், எங்களுடைய கொள்கைக்கு எங்களுடைய தன்மானத்துக்கு எங்களுடைய சுயமரியாதைக்கு ஒரு குந்தகம் விளைவிக்கும் என்றால் அதற்கு நாங்கள் தயாராக இல்லை.
And we have our reporters joining us for more on the story. Nanitha joining us from the capital and Vivek joining us from Chennai. As far as the DMK is concerned, Vivek, I'll come to you first. They did leave this morning for New Delhi. They will, of course, reach in a few minutes from now is what we're hearing. As far as the DMK is concerned, it's now clear that there could be some sort of a division within the party ranks itself. We're hearing that, for one, Alagiri is adamant on quitting and he's made that clear. And we're also hearing that Stalin has asked party leaders to wait.
Well, there is a subtle difference of opinion within the DMK, as you said. Alagiri, from day one, is a man who wanted to go alone, who does not want any truck with the Congress. That essentially is also because he wants more of his own men in the southern districts. He wants more seats for himself. And if the Congress is gone, he can surely accommodate his people. But the difference of opinion, as I said, is not a major one. Right now, what we know is DMK has toughened its stance. Congress, since, has called off the bluff. Congress does not seem to be buckling under DMK pressure. DMK now forced to send its people. Now, at 11 o'clock, we are told that these men will be made the Prime Minister in the, at the Parliament House and submitting their resignation. Congress, it seems, is in no way to give way to what DMK has said, because probably what the DMK senior leadership has thought is that, like it had happened earlier, the Congress will perhaps call them up and will agree to those 63 seats and also give them the seats that they wanted. But till late last night, there has been no development from the Congress side. Congress senior leadership, cadres and senior leaders have decided that they will not go by what DMK has said, and they will, if required, go alone in this elections. Niranjan?
But Vivek, do stay on with us. We also have Nanita joining us for more detail. Nanita, as far as the Congress is concerned, we believe there was a call made from the finance minister to DMK ranks. What are your sources telling you? What kind of a call was that? Was that a last-ditch attempt from the Congress to save the alliance?
Well, we understand, Ranjan, that late last night, Pranab Mukherjee, you know, after he returned in the evening from Arjun Singh's funeral in Madhya Pradesh, he did make a call to T.R. Balu, senior leader of the DMK, and the man who's really been negotiating from the DMK side with the Congress. And there was talk, but the Congress has made it clear that they're not going to climb down on their demand when it comes to the choice of constituencies and even the number of seats. And that really has caused a more hardening of stance as far as the Congress is concerned. And now, as time passes by and without any of the sides really blinking first, it's becoming more apparent that perhaps this pre-poll alliance is not going to stay and both sides are going to fight it out all alone. Senior members of the Congress still saying that after the election the situation is very fluid and we'll see how things go on from there. But the one thing that is quite clear is that the Congress has decided that it's not going to give in to the DMK, and it has decided that it can battle it out alone in Tamil Nadu. There is also speculation of a tie-up perhaps with the AIADMK, but no commitment on that yet. It still remains in the realm of speculation.